We've been studying linear equations now for a couple of weeks. I want to take a few minutes out of your time now and discuss a business application of linear equations. Our goal today is to solve business problems using linear equations. Rags LTD, a clothing firm, has fixed costs of $10,000 a year. These costs, such as rent, maintenance, and so on, must be paid no matter how much the company produces. To produce X units of a certain kind of suit, it costs $20 per suit or unit in addition to the fixed cost. That is, the variable cost of producing X of these suits is $20x. These costs are due to the amount produced and stem from items such as material, wages, fuel, and so on. The total cost, C of X, of producing X units a year is given by the function C. C of X is equal to the variable cost, which was given as 20x, plus the fixed cost, equal to $10,000. So our cost function is equal to 20x plus 10,000. Graph the cost function, and then what is the total cost of producing 100 suits and 400 suits? Let's take a look at the graph. Of course, this should remind you of sloped intercept form of a line, where our slope would be equal to 20 and our y-intercept is equal to 10,000. Now, I already graphed it for you. Maybe a little difficult to see, but the x-axis goes by 100s, and this would be the number of suits. And the y-axis is the total cost in dollars, and it goes by thousands. So right here is our y-intercept of 10,000. And so forth. And you can find various points on the line, but I've already graphed it for us. Okay, the question was, how much does it cost to produce 100 suits? Well, by looking at the graph, of course, you could just go to 100 up to the function over to the y-axis and see that it's going to be $12,000. 400 suits over here on the far right go up to the function, and you can see that it's going to be, looks like, $18,000. Now let's go back to the previous slide just for a moment. Another way to figure that out, of course, would just be to find C of 100, just to verify our graph. It would be 20 times 100 plus 10,000. And of course, you can check this, but it is going to be $12,000. And for C of 400, same process. It'd be 20 times 400 now, plus the fixed cost of 10,000, which this is going to be 8,000 plus 10,000 or 18,000, the same as what the graph showed. Again, I'm just doing the substitution into the cost function. Okay, let's move along now. When a business sells an item, it receives the price paid by the customer. This is normally greater than the cost to the business for producing the item. Well, let's hope so. The total revenue that a business receives is the product of the number of items sold and the price paid per item. So if Riggs Limited sells X suits at $80 per unit or per suit, the total revenue would simply be 80 times X. So our revenue equation or revenue function R of X is equal to the unit price, which is $80, times the units sold, which is X, which gives us 80X. Remember, cost, of course, is the money going out the door. Revenue is the money coming in the door. The total profit, which is what most businesses are concerned about, the total profit that a business receives is the amount left over after all the costs have been subtracted from the revenue. Thus, if P of X represents the total profit where X items are produced and sold, we have the profit P of X is equal to the revenue R of X minus cost C of X. Determine the profit and draw its graph using the same set of axes as was used for the graph in the previous example. And I've already graphed this, so let's go ahead and take a look at it. Here in black, we have our cost equation, and notice as you produce more and more suits, the cost goes up. In blue, we have the revenue equation. Again, notice that as you sell more and more units, of course, your revenue is going to increase. Now, when your costs are more than your revenue, of course, in this region, you have a loss. When the revenue is higher than the cost, of course, you have a gain or a profit. And right here in the middle here, we call this where there's no profit or no loss, this would be the break-even point. A company will break even at that value of X for which P of X equals zero, meaning you're not losing any money, but you're not gaining any money either. This point is at which the revenue is equal to the cost. Find the break-even value of X. Remember that our revenue function was 80X and our cost function was 20X plus 10,000. So if we want to know where that point is, where we won't make any money, we won't lose any money, we need to set these two functions equal to each other and solve. Let's try it. When is the revenue, 80X, equal to the total cost? Now notice that the only unknown is the number of suits. Let's solve for X. So I'll subtract 20 on both sides. So I'll subtract 20X on both sides. Divide by 60 on both sides. X comes out to 166.6 repeating. So we probably would just round this to 167. So in order for this company to break even selling suits, they have to sell 167 suits. Now with that, we could go back and we can figure out a lot. With that, we could go back and find some additional information if we wanted to. If we found C of 167, we could find our total cost. If we found R of 167, we could go back and find what our revenue must be to break even. And then lastly, if we find P of 167, since this is our break-even point, we would know that should be zero. Now this is rounded, so it'll be a little bit off, but that should be true. I hope that helps explain how you can use linear equations to solve some basic business applications. Have a great day.